hello, internet world. Big Mike here. I'm back at the tying bench. Today we're going to tie a fly that I call the Captain J. It's named after a customer and a friend, a Facebook friend, over in the Galveston Bay area named Captain Jerome McCown. Captain Jerome is a saltwater fly fishing guide in the Galveston Bay area, and he likes to use my flies. So first, we're going to start off with the hook. It's a Mustad 3407 in size 1. It's a strong saltwater hook. We'll clamp that in the vise, nice and tight. Slide over a little bit. And I'm tying this in an olive color. These flies are going down to a tackle shop outfitter down in Mandeville, Louisiana, called Martian Bayou. If you're in the area, go in and check out Ben and his place there, and see what he's got to offer. He's got a lot of nice stuff. So we're going to start our thread up here at the hook eye, come back a little ways, and we're going to snip that thread off. Now this fly has a little bit of weight on it. I use these little small black hourglass weights. I'm going to tie one of those up right behind the hook eye on top of the hook shank. Tie it in nice and tight. Because I've tied it up here on top of the hook shank, when the fly's in the water, it's going to ride upside down with the hook point riding up, which helps make it weedless. It's not 100% weedless, but it'll avoid most of the weeds. We're going to run our thread all the way to the back. And go around where the hook shank starts to bend. And we're going to tie in what's called a hot spot. And for this, I use a material called ice chenille in a fiery orange color, size large. We'll tie that in. Back here. My thread's not wanting to cooperate with me. Okay. Tie that down real tight and then run our thread back up the hook shank. Now we're going to wrap this chenille around the hook shank going in the direction opposite that we wrapped the thread. We're not going to come all the way up the hook shank. We're just going to come around the bend to the point where the hook shank straightens out. And we're going to tie that down. And we're going to snip off the chenille. Now, whenever I'm snipping material off the fly, I always take my index finger and push the bobbin and the thread out of the way, because I don't want to accidentally snip my thread. Then I'd have to start all over. Next step, we're going to put the tail on this. And for the tail, I use a material called craft fur. It's very slinky. It's a synthetic material. It comes on this patch like this. And I'm going to snip off a bunch. Like so. Now this craft fur has a lot of short fuzzy fibers up here on the end where it was attached to the patch. And we're going to try and pull all of those out of there. If we don't, we won't be able to tie the fur down onto the hook real well. Plus, this helps eliminate some bulk on the fly. And we got all that out of there. And we're going to just kind of trim all that off evenly. You see all this fuzz that I pulled out of it. I don't throw that away. I keep that because I use it for material, dubbing material, for some other flies that I make. So I'm going to set that over to the side. Now we're going to take our batch of craft fur, get all the loose stuff out, set that on top of the hook shank, and make two wraps and pull the thread straight down to tighten those wraps. Pulling it straight down so that the material doesn't spin around to the side of the hook. Now we've got that tied down nicely. At this point, we're gonna flip the fly over. Like so. And we're going to put on some legs. For the legs, I use these silicone legs. They're made out of silicone rubber. Same stuff that the skirts on a spinnerbait are made out of. We're going to lay those legs diagonally across the hook shank. Take a couple wraps. Next, we're going to add some flash to the tail. For that, I use a product called Flashaboo. It's basically little strips of mylar that come in all kind of different colors. I don't know how well you're able to see that, but it adds some flash. This is a color called pearl. It's kind of clear, colorless. So it comes in a fairly long strand. I folded it in half, snipped it into two pieces. And again, we're gonna lay that diagonally across the hook shank, taking a couple wraps. So now we have half of the legs and the mylar pointing toward the tail of the fly, and half of it's pointing toward the eye of the fly. We're gonna take that port all that material that's pointing forward, we're going to fold that back towards the table. Pinch it down and take a few wraps. Now everything's pointing backwards toward the tail. That mylar is a little long, the flashaboo. So what we're going to do is trim it to length. Okay. So we've got our hot spot, we've got our tail, our legs, our flash. At this point, we're going to put the head on the fly. And to do that, we're going to use a material called ice dub. It's ice dubbing. This is in the olive brown color. It's a very flashy material. So to do that, we're going to pull out a length of string, wrap it around a thread, wrap it around our finger, and come up back around the hook shank, over the two threads that are on our finger, and under, back around the hook shank, and we're going to run our thread back up to the eye of the hook. At this point, we slide that into position and rest our thread on it to keep our thread out of the way. Then we get a tool called a dubbing spinner. It's got two little arms on it, two little hooks. And we're going to put that on the thread, which forms that loop. And just let it hang there. Now to help our dubbing stick to the thread as we're preparing it, we're going to take what's called dubbing wax. Just put a little bit on that thread. Spread it out even. Now we take a pinch of this dubbing. And we want to kind of spread it out. And we're going to take that and we're going to put it between, on the inside of the loop, between the two threads. Slide it up to the top. We'll grab another pinch. Going to spread it out. Put it in underneath or below that first batch. Now if you can see this, it's captured within that loop between the two threads, sticking out on both sides. But it's not secure in there. So what we're going to do, we're going to take our finger and we're going to pinch at the bottom of the dubbing material. Pinch the two threads together. And then we're going to spin that dubbing spinner as so. And when we let go of the pinch, it spins up and gets captured in that loop, in that thread. At this point, I like to take this little brush and just kind of fluff it out. Okay. Now with our rotary vise, we're going to start spinning that fly, wrapping this dubbing around the hook shank. being careful not to trap those legs or that flash underneath it. And as I'm doing this, I like to take my brush and just kind of brush it out as we're going, brushing it to the rear. Take a couple more wraps. Brush it out to the rear. Repeating as we work our way up to the eye of the fly. Once I get up right behind those lead eyes, I take a few wraps. Brush it out. Now we're going to capture that with our thread. Take three or four wraps back there. Again, hold our thread out of the way and snip off that dubbing loop. Now we're ready to finish off the fly. So we're going to take our whip finisher, which is basically a tool that wraps the thread over itself. And I take seven wraps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Notice I'm wrapping in front of the lead eyes. Pull that secure. Snip off our thread. The final step is I take a product called Bone Dry. It's a very thin epoxy that is cured or hardened with UV light, ultraviolet light. So we're going to coat thread where we whip finished. We're going to coat the thread over those eyes. And we're going to hit it with our magic wand, the ultraviolet flashlight. It only takes about 10 seconds for that stuff to harden up. Once it's hard, this fly will never come untied. It might get chewed up, but it's not coming untied. And there we have it. The Captain Jet. It's a great fly for redfish, speckled trout, snook, largemouth, smallmouth, bass, striped bass. And that's what she looks like. Let's see how close we can get. All right, friends and neighbors, till next time, if you're in the Galveston Bay area and you're looking to catch some fish, look up my buddy Captain Jerome McCown. He's on Facebook. He'll take you out, show you a good time, and try to get out on the water catch some fish, stay safe, and tight lines, everybody.